the greatest prospects we have ever seen against the best player in the world, Luke Humphries.
In a last leg decider. Well, we know how the World Championship final ended, don't we? But these two, well, they've met five times since then, and all five have been won by the 17-year-old. So who wins this time then? To guide you through our first semi-final of the night, hand you over to Wayne Mardell and Stuart Pike.
Yes, and you think it's a rivalry that is going to last a generation, certainly a darting generation. Luke Littler and Luke Humphries, you feel, have already done enough to book their spots at the O2. I've got going to say in May, next month, it is next month, yep. The finals night. Wow, has it flown. These two have been absolutely outstanding. Top and second in the table. And 24 points in the last couple of years has been enough to get into those semi-finals. Stand by your beds. It'll be another cracker.
Yeah, might be more than 24 this year, mind, because the majority of points now, aren't they? Rob Cross, Price and Peter Wright becoming a little detached. Michael Smith now on 17 points. So Rob Cross, who's in sixth, he's 5 points detached from the player in fifth, which is Michael Smith. But Luke Littler, 58. Looking to make it three on the bounce, just like Michael van Gerwen has done and Luke Humphries has done. Hell of an achievement to do that in this year's Premier League with the standard as it is.
100.
Whoever wins this Luke game will finish top this evening, not overall.
Yep. Spot on.
58.
Luke Littler far from his best against Rob Cross. Had to win the last two legs. He survived the match dark, but
94.
Not a bad sign that since the Ali Pali, he's been not at his best quite a lot of the time, but hasn't stopped him winning.
No. Double 16.
96.
Yeah, Littler was 3-1 down to Cross, and Humphries was 4-1 down to Peter Wright. It's been a chore for them.
60.
Yeah, five consecutive legs for Humphries.
Game
make that six
Murphy
with winning the opening Luke leg.
Hold the throw. On. Said it before, say it again. Winning that bullseye in the practice room can be huge. And recent form will tell you that last leg deciders are not Humphries' favourite. He had gone 0-9 in last leggers. But he won at the weekend, won a decider, so that will make him feel a little bit better. He was seven darts into a nine against Peter Wright, and he's kicked off Max here. Another! Go on then!
140.
Pathetic.
Selfish.
Yeah. Good dart, just clattered into the previous one.
81.
Looks in the mood, Humphries. A slow start against Peter Wright. Complaining a little bit of fatigue. He has played a lot of darts. He's not missed anything, basically, since the Ali Pali. But in control here. Possible 10 darter to go two up. Possible.
131. Oh.
What a leg of darts. You leave 36 after 9 and he may not get a shot to come back. You do, and what do you do with it?
Game shot the second leg. Luke Humphries. Third leg, it's
2-0.
Humphries to throw first.
But what an attempt at the 1-5-1 from Luke Littler.
Wasn't watching, was he? But he knew.
Yeah, you hear the shout. I'm never a fan of people that don't watch. I just think you can learn a lot from what your player's doing. Because a player can hit a 180 and throw three poor darts, you can see them snatch and snatch again. Whereas if you just hear it, it's like, well, they're playing well. Not necessarily.
99.
I used to watch Webby throw. Ridiculous. Oh, Webby. Can't defend
140.
Yourself.
140.
You were stood behind him a fair deal.
Both players
57.
Already found their rhythm, but it's Littler who is doing the chasing right now. Look at this. Oh, come on now. He hit the 57 and a 54 at the beginning of the 151.
93.
Just
Luke
happening
McCoy,
for
90.
Him right now.
Brilliant leg, 12 dart break, straight back from Luke Littler.
Full
little nod of approval for the way he played in that leg. It is a fantastic rivalry, producing some stunning dart.
He took out that 90 against Rob Cross. Took it out again. Littler averaging 112. Humphries just 102. I say just, I was being facetious. Come on. We know he loves a nine. Is it one on the European Tour? Is it one in a World Series event? A Pro Tour? Now is he going to hit one in a Premier League?
141. Minus 60. Could have climbed the 57.
121.
We're still giving the crowd a run for their money, acknowledged by his opponent. The two loops with great respect, and Littler has left 20 after 9.
Incredible. Two legs ago, Humphries left 36 after 9, now 20 after 9. Wow.
10.
That was just a little messy with the first dart. That was a mile away from where he was aiming. I guarantee you he's aiming for the outside wire at a double 10.
Yeah, good dart. Yeah, aggressive. 109, Luke Littler average.
He's already had the highest average of this year's Premier League, 114 against Michael van Gerwen.
I just think that these two,
so simple,
yeah, bring the best out of each other.
Yeah,
time and time again.
Yeah, the pace of play, everything about him is just rhythm. Rhythm, timing, all what you want to do. These two just help each other do it. He's on it again. Oh, come on, stop this. Well, don't stop it, carry on.
Well, this time. Last time it was 180. This time 177, 180.
This is easiest, Stu. 60, 24. The width of a wire, look, from champ to champ, from...
36.
I've got to say, I fancied that so much. So much.
He's giving everyone a run for their money tonight, Luke Littler.
96.
Luke, that was a poor visit. But a brilliant ending. Another 12 darter. Absolutely magnificent. That was a smile, I think, of acknowledgement and approval as well. Last three legs, totally unplayable.
74.
Yeah, decent scoring from Luke.
58.
He just brought so much joy to the sport that we love.
Oh, come on!
Last four legs, 171, 180, 180, 177, 180, 180.
No one's made darts look this simple, really, since Michael van Gerwen in his absolute peak. Michael Smith gave it a go a couple of years ago, but this is just magnificent. The flow, the ease of it, the freedom. Said it before. He does what he likes. 10,000 now singing Luke Littler. And now the peacockery starts again with the last 60.
58. Luke required 52.
For four on the spin.
Ah, oh, please! This is brutal. The world champ, the world number one, the Grand Slam champ, the
57.
Grand Prix champ, the Players champ, he's a bystander. He's an absolute watcher of a great game of darts here. Oh, stop! Oh, we did.
He's got four on the spin after being 2-0 down. And losing that second leg after missing top for a 1-5-1.
And when we say a barrage about, it's the way that when these good players play, it's about 94. Them. When they play well, it's about them. Littler is absolutely just, he's cemented that. He's cemented that when he plays well, the game is about him. And it'll happen with other players as well.
Rebels in it. Loves it. Absolutely loves it.
100.
Don't forget, he's 17 years of age.
I did not know that.
Just sometimes you kind of shake your head. He's 17.
Yeah, I get it. It is utterly ridiculous how good he is and the composure he's got and everything he does that a 17-year-old can do. He, Michael van Gerwen and Eric Bristow, I think, for teenagers, have been on a different level in darts.
96. Luca requiring 94.
Eric would have absolutely loved watching Littler strike his stuff. 54 tops.
What a joy it is to watch this young man play dart.
Apparently I say come on now quite a lot, but come on now! The dart falling out, the pause, the resettling, the recalibration to then hit 54 tops. Luke Humphries has absolutely walked into this. But, Stuart, it's only what he's been doing to everyone else this year, Luke Humphries.
Not out of it. Against the dart, Littler, don't forget, stepping up to throw for the match here, but 180, 140 from Humphries.
Yeah.
59.
Yeah, the Premier League does seem to offer up a load of darting drama, game in, game out.
58.
And this isn't done and dusted yet. Because if Littler does get broken, then Humphries holds, then it's 5-4. Well, now he wants 167. This would not surprise me one iota. Surprise me now.
99. Luca requires 68.
To stay in it, the world champ. One dart. For Humphries. Oh, well done. Hit the double 16. Luke had Humphries. To hit the double 8. Does hit the double 8. Not breaks the Littler throw after losing five consecutive legs.
Humphries knows that if he can hold it, it could get a little iffy for the spectacular Littler.
125.
Worth mentioning, because I think back of 3 years ago watching Luke Littler play in a JDC final in front of 20 people in Milton Keynes, and he was just far, he was just too good for his opponent.
Yeah,
as a 14-year-old, and you kind of wondered what we're going to get and what the future would hold for Luke Littler in the world of darts. Well,
96.
As you mentioned it at the start, worth mentioning again, as Humphries with a superb 180 kicks it in it brilliantly. 140 for Littler. 140 for Littler. 140 for Littler. Match start missed.
Luke required 83.
Luke hit a 180 and needed every point of it. Tops, tops now. Oh, look at this. Look at this.
Luke Humphries.
These are the elite. That is the world champ. And do you know what? Walk straight past Littler as if to say, I mean business, pal. There was no kind of looking at each other thinking, come on, let's have a little fandango and enjoy it. There's no enjoyment here. They just want to get it won.
140. Yeah, you were talking about Forbes' list of the 50 most influential.
30 under 30.
139.
And Luke Littler
is in it.
He's in it. Forbes. Not Darts World, Forbes! What?
I'll tell you what, Luke Humphries isn't finished here.
Ah, this is just great. The pace of play, the accuracy, the 180s, everything about this is just fantastic.
140! Luke requires 126.
He's missed a match dart for a 140. Needs the treble 19, doesn't get the treble 19.
54.
And all of a sudden, Humphries to level.
Well, he's taken out 68, 83, now leads the bullseye.
62.
That would have made him favourite for this darts match. A match in where he lost five legs on the bounce. For a place in the final for 3 weeks running. Tops!
52. Luca requires 25.
So two match darts have come and gone. And Luke Humphries, the world champ, makes it 5-all. He was 5-2 down. Magnificent from Humphries, you've got to say. And he is favourite. Yes. He's throwing in a decider.
2-0 up, 5-2 down. 60. All the spectacular visits were coming from this man. But all Humphries could do was kick off with a treble-less visit, followed by the same from Littler.
Got to say, we've been extolling the virtues quite rightly of Luke Littler, but this has been something special as well from Luke Humphries.
Yeah. Look, he's the world number one, he's the world champ, and I ruled off all everything else in one. Littler is a magician, but this man is an absolute machine of a darts player. Humphries is the world number one because he is the best player on the planet.
To force that through. Still, you would think advantage for Luke Humphries.
50.
Maybe not now.
No, definitely not now. Six darts off 208. Very doable. It's quite doable now. That's his fifth. And Littler will return. For 28 for a place in the final.
I'll leave it to you. I'm shaking my head in disbelief.
No worries. Takes his time. Picks his darts back up.
28.
Here, 180 to leave it. Humphries sitting on 131. Does not get a pop. The 60 at the start of that leg seemed to dictate what was to come. That is the sixth match running that Littler has got the better of Luke Humphries. 5-180s, 107 average. He has won the last 2 weeks in the Premier League. He's in the final again. Who will he be playing? Will it be him?